Yes, I was two times in Senegal. So I was at the big opening in Senegal, and there were even sponsored from Germany some solar panels, because we think that also the application of mathematics in different fields is very, very important. And we have to build up some connection to industry to strengthen Africa also in the economic power. Therefore, I was active to get some support from Germany to send the solar panels, and I heard that the next 4 months they will install this at the AIM Center in Senegal. Oh, okay, there were always traditional, some good connection to Africa. I remember when I was a young boy, we heard always of Albert Schweitzer in Africa, the support of Africa. But today I am more realistic. I see the big gradient between Europe and Africa. And we always have in the newspapers the transfer of people crossing the borders to Italy, and they want to protect the borders, so like in the United States, between Mexico and the United States. But this is scientifically is impossible. So we have to build to reduce these gradients, that we have this diffusion. And therefore, I think we are obliged to reduce this gradient, and it's partly also the educational gradient and scientific gradient. If you look at the productivity in science, Africa is really behind most parts of the world. And therefore, we have the duty to do something. And I think AIMS is the ideal possibility to educate a generation which is able to educate as a university, to change some behaviors in Africa. And I think this is some support to strengthen internally the country and the continent. And for me, the idea of AIMS is really the best way to start with relatively small amount of money, with small groups, to demonstrate that excellences are very important, the selection procedure is very important, and to have a demonstrator that you can build up something which is different from the present situation. Okay, first of all, to be optimistic, to look positive in the future, so, and to contribute with your knowledge to the future. And okay, I'm a person who's working basic science, and I'm always happy to work at the front of our knowledge, to see something in nature which I don't understand, and to give an answer, and to be convinced that humans should be able to solve problems and to find an answer. So this fight to understand nature, this is for me the driving force, and to be the first one to have some new knowledge. And then later, every time we have some new knowledge, you will find also some application. We have very often the discussion about is it useful for industry, our knowledge. And I have the idea, so if you have new knowledge, if you go to the past, then you have always also some application. When Einstein made his theories, nobody believed that may be application, but today we know that GPS will not be operating without using the ideas of Albert Einstein. And the modern quantum theory was developed using Einstein's ideas. And so therefore also the topic, the next Einstein from Africa, is for me is a very, very good name, because Einstein, when he made his big discoveries, he was outside the community. He was in the patent office in Switzerland, and he was not involved in the general thinking of the past. So he could have some breakthroughs. If you have just using your brain, if you look at the nature, then you may have some new ideas. And I think in Africa, everyone has the same starting point in principle, and he has not the old-fashioned ideas, he's not kept by some ideas which was from the past. And then you can say, okay, now I have a quite different idea and have to break through, like Einstein. Therefore, next Einstein from Africa, there's a good chance, because everyone has a chance, to have breakthroughs in new thinking. Yeah, I was in favor for a long time. You know, the big Desert Hack project to have all the energy collected in Sahara, and then in principle all the world could be delivered the energy necessary just from a small part of Africa. But then you need stability, then you need the infrastructure. And this is one of the big problems, the stability in Africa. Nobody will invest in Africa if he has no guarantee that there are stable countries. Yes, and they should use their resources. They should not just sell the resources, the minerals, to all over the world. They should really think about to use their resources. And for this you need education, you need scientists. And I think Africa is rich in these resources. So we have to find some clever ideas how to make out something profitable on these resources. Because many, many other countries think, okay, Africa is a very nice area where we can collect our the resources and we will make the products outside of Africa. But there must be now the idea, we are strong enough, we have the resources, we have to build up the capacity, intellectual capacity to use this resource in a very efficient way.